Big blast blew off about 5 minutes ago, and it's over at Paul Matthews' place. There's a trailer over there with its front door blown up, and there's a person out there trying to manipulate it. Make no mistake, I believe it's a meth lab that just blew up. And when I find out, I'm calling the cops. Let them Mamones take care of this problem. Guy's standing right there, you see him?
Yeah. Well, I really can't because I'm not.
You better see.
Honey,
you see that yellow thing? That's the top of the roof.
Okay. I have a bad eye, so you
I don't want, you're on tape right now, so don't give me no excuses, honey.
I'm not making excuses.
Don't make me jump. I'm taking pictures to do this. You understand me?
I'm looking there. I can't.
I don't want to hear it. See, be quiet. You're not very good at being a partner right now.
I'm not trying to be a partner.
Shut up.
I'm trying to look.
Shut up. I can barely see it with this camera, so just shut up.
Thank you. I'm glad.
Shut up. Okay, that's about it. I got to deal with Lisa and this idiot over here. Sure looks like it's torn up. It's 854, just called dispatch. I'll send a call service to make verify this. Nobody's hurt. And if this is not a bomb or something. There it is. Come on, Mike, put your light on it. The work, the light. Did your light work?
Yeah, you got guns?
Fuck the guns, man.
Well, I ain't worried about the gun. I don't know if anybody's hurt.
We ain't going near there. Let the cops come. We're just here observing. It's on tape.
So what blew up?
Look at that shit. What do you see? I've never seen anything like that.
We're gonna find out here.
I wish you would. Bring it over here. Mike Garrison and Jim Patel are on the scene here before the sheriffs come so we can see if anybody's hurt. I don't see anybody walking around or doing anything right now. Guy in the white truck over there in Matthew's old trailer isn't moving. Lights are on, but nobody's moving. This is scary stuff, folks. Can't see anything, Mike. Gotta get closer. Can't see nothing.
Can't see anything. You ain't got that light on there right.
Doesn't that look like the front of it's blowing up?
Well, there was an explosion. I checked all the tires in the semi down over there.
I know your neighbors are freaking.
I know.
So was everybody else, but nobody had the cojones.
Well, I do.
Well, we're here. Okay.
I do.
Let me get this. Keep it steady.
I don't know what it looked like beforehand.
Well, it sure didn't look like that, dude. I seen two guys malingering around there. I told the cops.
If it blew up, they ain't moving around now.
Yeah, they were when I was out in the backyard. Check my property.
Well, there's something going on here.
a bus over there and no sheriff that were over here by Glen Cove, and they might be going down Carroll to Gon. We don't know. Yep, they're coming from Carroll Street, Mike. Carroll Street, Mike. Hit it over here. Hit the light over here towards Carroll. He's coming down Carroll. See him? The fire department's coming. I told them there was no fire, but they figured it was a meth lab. Okay, that's engine number whatever. And the bus is behind, but I don't see a sheriff. It's all right, keep the light on there, man. You ain't burning nothing but daylight. Keep the light on the property. We'll find it. At least we're in the easement here. We're not anywhere near that fucking place.
Pretty sure the explosion came from there.
I don't give a fuck. It doesn't look right.
All I know is something blew up here.
I couldn't get my binoculars because Lisa's not a very good helper. She's a scared rabbit. Okay. Scared to death.
Driveway, right?
Yeah, they're coming down the racetrack. Just keep that light there. Keep it on the trailer. I want them to see if that's fucked, screwed up or what. To me, it looks like a parachute. But where is everybody? The lights are on and nobody's home. And we heard an explosion, so we're not doing anything out of the ordinary.
No.
That's good. As long as we're on the same page, explain it. Whether it's
I don't see nobody on the ground nowhere.
The fence there. As long as we're checking it out, like I told them on the deal, we're checking it out for safety reasons. Sound like a bomb, and it could be a lab blown up. No smoke, no fire. Sure looks like it's blown up though, eh? Keep the light on there. Keep it on there.
I can't tell in the front of it.
Looks like a parachute over the light, dude. Huh? It looks like a parachute over the light. I'm not kidding you. Looks like a parachute over the light. And the fire department's there.
Coming down the wrong road. They go show them over here.
Men. They're leaving. They didn't even stop and say hello to us. What's this guy doing over here? What the frig is going on, man? 9:17 p.m. Come on, pull over, man. What's up?
Can I help you?
Yeah, we got an explosion we heard over here. Yeah, I understand. We thought it was over here, but it looked like a tarp over the trailer. Orange tarp. At this trailer back here, we were flashing the lights for everybody. There's a trailer. There was two guys looking around when I first called. Like from a distance, it looked like the top blew off, and it's like a parachute thing or something like this, and it's showing orange and black.
Where was this at?
Right back here at the Matthews.
This way?
At the Matthews house.
Where?
The Matthews house.
Matthews, don't know.
Okay.
I don't know who Matthew is.
An idiot. But anyway, you go down this street we came up,
uh-huh.
That's where his house is.
Okay.
Nobody's moving. I've been there since 2 minutes after this thing blew off. I took the camera out after I saw where it was. We checked our properties, my neighbor and I. And nobody's moving from that. There's a single wide and there's two travel trailers in this little RV park.
Okay, I was going to say, because I saw some people out there walking around. There's like, it looks like a mannequin sitting in a chair in front of the house or something.
Yeah, it's like a parachute over the light. I thought it looked like it blew up from my distance over here. And I walked up to him and he had his lights on when you're here, and I said, no, it's a tarp. But we don't know. This thing was a bomb that blew up and shook us worse than an A-10 Warthog flying off.
Yeah, because we had somebody down over there with the 18-wheeler in the yard describe it as their guys saw it over off of Carroll Street blowing a bunch of debris around over there.
They saw somebody blow up?
They said it was in a fenced area over there off of Carroll Street. So that's why we're headed back that way to kind of look around there. Chief's over there. We'll just keep scouting the area. So.
Yeah, never know.
Yeah.
All right.
All right, if you see anything else, try to let me know.
Yeah, I will. I'll call dispatch.
Okay. All right. That makes it easier.
Yep, thank you. I'll be damned. I want to know who it is. He's going right by me. I had to wave him down. He won't even talk. Yes. We don't know. No cops came.
We got the fire crews and everything here.
No, I called the sheriff and they were going to send a car. They never did,
why
Deanna.
Why didn't they just get Fire Chief Scott Lewis?
He ain't a cop.
Yeah, they don't need a cop. They need the fire to find out what's going on. Then they call the cops.
I never heard such nonsense.
That's how it works. Right behind you, right?
I don't care. I can't believe that. Did you hear what Deanne O'Donnell just said? That they check it with the fire, then they send the cops. I got her on tape. She's talking to the cops on a scanner. She might have a two-way radio. Lewis is right with her. They won't come near me. They're fucking corrupt. Come on, Lewis. He's walking around now. He ain't even coming near me. I can't believe this skullduggery, honey. See, I am away from her, man. She's an idiot. Well, she's grassed. When she said I got on tape, on the camera. Camera, here comes Chief Lane.
Are you filming me?
No, I'm taking notes. What's up? Where's the cops? Did we hear a bomb? Everybody heard the thing shake the shit out of us.
I'm trying to figure out what it was.
I don't know where it is. I thought it was this trailer over here. These creeps over here put a tarp over the light when I first called in.
Where though?
Right fucking here. Right by that street light. There's a trailer park.
Down there more.
You go down this road. Follow me.
I can do that.
Follow me because I'm going home that way.
Okay.
Ah, Scott Lewis. Scott Lewis. Are you filming me? I said, yeah. Now they're gonna check Matthew's place. They're checking around, looking. I told the cops that. He said, there's no cops here. I'm still recording on my camera. So I told him, follow me. Follow me. He's coming now, him and that fat ass Deanne. Their pal. Get him on the news. All right, just listen. Put you down. He's going in there. He's going in there with his lights on. I'm taping it. Good. If you don't get out of his car, then there's something really weird going. He knows I'm taping him too. He's backing up and he ain't getting out of his car yet. My God, he never got out. He's coming right back out, Lisa. No, he's coming over to the other trailer with the white SUV. He ain't got out of his vehicle yet.
Now he might. Yeah, he's getting out. He's getting out and he's flashing his light at me. What a jackass. There's some coverage. They're covering up for somebody. Nobody's coming out of that trailer. Nobody's coming to him at all. He's got his lights on and everything. All right, just let me alone right now. Just stay on the line and listen. How come he's not getting out of his car? How come nobody's coming out to see him? There's lights on in the trailer. SUV's there, the truck's there. This is strange. And then where's Deanne O'Donnell? I want to know where that reporter is. That's crazy, man. She's gone. Oh, she's at the corner waiting. Scott's out of his car now. It's 9:33 p.m. on August 16th, 2012. Looking around, nobody's coming, nobody's anywhere. Not a body, not a soul. This is bizarre city here. Going into the gate now, the white SUV trailer. Nope, it won't get in. Come on, Scott Lewis. Deanne is at the end of the corner with her scanner, two-way radio, I believe. Got somebody. You got somebody. Arguing with him. Guy's saying no explosion, no nothing. He's trying to do something. They're arguing about Lewis's flashlight in his face. Guy's denying anything, anything, nothing. Just me and Scott Lewis. No sheriff, no nothing. What if the guy had a weapon and Lewis is unarmed, unprepared, him or me gets popped? Do they call a cop or they call the bus? Your guess is as good as mine. How he gets to come in. So he gets to come in now with authorization from the whoever's that are living in that little trailer on Matthew's property. At least it was when I last heard. So he's checking. This is really strange in our neighborhood. Paul Matthews. He's arguing with the people now. Come on, Scott, find out what's going on, man. You got the badge and the shirt and the cop car. Nobody's coming out of the single wide with the white pickup sitting there. Lights are still on. Nobody's showing their face, just like these people had to be pushed out by Scott. This is so bizarre. It needs to be looked at from now on. And he hasn't been over to the two RVs yet. The one with the fake orange light. The parachute type covering over the light. Lights inside, nobody's around now. It's like they all disappeared. I think this is the place. It was that close. Not Carroll Street. Let's check over at the other single wide now. That's good. Let's see if he does. Yeah, he's going over there. I don't know prepared for any of this nonsense. Can't see him. Or not. There's that door. Firecracker. They're telling them that it was a firecracker, a big white blast. North of this property on May and Carroll and Gann. Complaining about Mike's tenants. They're trying to blame Mike's people. These people don't know what they're talking about. Fireworks? This was a fucking shake, earth-shattering bomb. I've never seen a firework do that. We're just complaining about them working all hours in the night. Mike, they're complaining about the Montreal people. These are real good neighbors, pal. They're burying your people right now with Chief Lewis. My landlord, he lives on Irons. That's Paul Matthews' new address. Oh, it scared them when it went off. Trying to deter him from checking any more here. Check all that stuff down there. I'm not going to let him. He has to check them two RV spots. Nice to see a man in uniform. Hey, Scott.
Yes.
You need to check the RVs back here.
Yeah, you thought he was going back down on the main
street. Right here. My guy got murdered here.
Everyone's reporting fireworks down over there.
Get a Marine over here, he's shook him up, he's fucking dead. He shook this out. This is what I saw from my place in the front. It looked like a big orange thing. And for a minute, I said, get my camera. He's arguing with me because he don't want to be scared. You going through here?
Yeah, just got to be careful. There's nothing.
Wait a minute, he fenced this whole shit up. So the only way you can get in is through Aura here. What the hell's that?
Hey, I'll see. Still searching here. Pretty deep into the back trailer area. Yeah, so far, it seems alright, though. I'll keep you posted. Alright, thanks. Everything cool there?
No, we haven't been over here. We're going to have to circle around and come through here because Matthew's turning us up. I think that guy was murdered.
I'll call you right back, okay, Bear?
When that guy was murdered.
Which one?
I don't know. I don't care.
They murdered some guy here. Mike knows more about it than I do. The cops were here and the state troopers. Highway guys, you know, the blue. So, no cars been here. I've been watching this for 2 weeks. This light came on all of a sudden.
Yeah.
Nobody around. And when I came and saw this, I seen two silhouettes in there tonight.
Okay. I don't see any evidence of something exploding here,
well,
though.
I heard them saying it was over by the people that moved in here 2 weeks ago.
Down there.
Because they're working on their stuff. They got some heavy-duty shit.
That's what he's telling me.
They work in Hollywood.
Okay.
And they got nice cars that make you drool. They're from Canada.
Okay. Well, I can come back tomorrow and check on those guys down here. But I don't see any obvious holes in the ground
or anything like that.
So I can't really go in that.
Like I told the sheriff, I said it was an explosion type thing. It looked like this trailer here comes to do a service check, and they send you guys. You're all over the place, the bus and everything.
I'm trying for you.
So I didn't go on the property. I had
yeah, we
Mike
can.
With the light go on there and with the light, and I just went up here and said it's just a fucking parachute over a light. I've never seen it ever here.
Well, I'll see what we do. I'll come back out tomorrow and talk to those guys about the city. If you're working, I'll check this or anything like that. Just to see, okay?
These guys, I heard about every word they said.
Yeah.
They're trying to pin us over here.
I don't think it was the same thing, but they were kind of pointing to the same thing too, actually.
Just well, I just said that these people here are living here. Mm-hmm. It's their expensive equipment.
Yeah.
They don't go up here. They're worried about their property or something.
Well, I'm going to ask Mark to take a look at that. I think it's just you can't
see
that.
You got everything.
Why can't you do
it? No, I mean tomorrow.
Oh, yeah, that's what I'm doing here.
You check everybody up, all the lights in the cops and their lights are on. Never seen that before.
Well, if you see anything else over here, you know what to do. It's cold.
Yeah, no problem. I got a kick out of these people, man. They didn't want to come out.
Well,
that's how
people, you know, people get nervous. They don't
know
who's down there.
Nice to see a man in here. I've never seen these people, brother. Okay? I know the owners on Iris. They had to leave here. They were told to leave. Their CPS would take their kids away because that single leg don't fit. He bought a piece of bankrupt property on irons and bragged about it. Bought it for 10 grand. That's where he was. Here you go. Alright, have fun.
Thank you.
Okay. And that's the end of the story. Woo! A fluke. Trying to blame the Canadians. Saying it's fireworks. There's Deanne O'Donnell driving around and she's DD Mile. Nothing going on here. And that's it, baby. Okay, that's it. You there? He's beeping his horn out. See how bad he is? He listened to those people. These people listen to the rats.
Oh, my God.
Think about it, Cindy. Tell your old man he ain't playing poppycock here. This is criminal shit they're doing. They're hiding something.
Yeah.
No cop, just Lewis, see? Send Lewis over there. Patel called.
When one of the guys were coming back home from Vegas, they were coming down here.
Where fucking Chuck Bailey lives? Well, I went right in front of Chuck Bailey's, and the only thing that looked out the window was a cat. Everything's lit up like a Christmas tree. Cars are parked in his yard like he's having a weekend party. Lewis don't stop. I watched him go all the way down Mayway. Your husband turned around and made turkey in your yard. I went down the road and followed Lewis all the way to 160 and Carroll, where he made a bitch turn and came back. That's when I stopped Deanne O'Donnell over here on May when she did a bitch in front of your gate. These people are fucked. They're at your fucking neighbor's backyard on Neutral Street right now.
Lewis himself. Deanne O'Donnell's probably close by. Yeah, you need to go back outside because I have my stupid gate that I won't unlock to open. And I don't want Lewis because he said, what are you, tape, are you filming me when he came up to me on Carroll? You better call me back. You fucking clown. He lied to me. He said he was coming tomorrow. He's listening to those scumbags at Matthew's.
Why didn't you check those trailers?
He didn't do it. He didn't want to do it.
But yet he would check his people.
Yep.
They're not even doing anything.
Nope. Cindy's going to take care of it. 7 o'clock, she saw some people playing over by Chuck Bailey's place.
Uh-huh.
When they were coming back from Vegas.
Uh-huh.
So either Chuck is doing something, but I went there and saw nothing. Just his lights all over his place. Nobody moving nowhere. Scott, why are you bothering our new neighbors here because those other scumbags told you that they're working all night?
Yeah, why didn't they check those people?
They didn't check the trailers. He said he can't go on the property. So what are we doing here? All you gotta do is go in the back here and come in because Mamone fenced it all off. You can't get to it from his house. If an emergency was happening, nobody can get to it. Matthews is a real weirdo, man. I wonder how much money he's making a month off of this shit. If there is any shit.
Well, for sure those people are doing something, selling drugs and stuff, and they're being protected.
Well, I told Scott there's a murder. He goes, what murder? I said, I don't freaking know. I don't care. All I know is that NHP and cops were there for hours and hours, and the Matthews had to leave because their trailer is unsafe for their kids. So that's why they're on iron. It's a piece of property they bought. Matthews bragged about it by paying $10,000. I told you they were over there. I never went to look, but this here did it for us. Cindy's mouth dropped. 10 o'clock and Scott Lewis is still over there talking to the Canadians and Cindy. And Lisa's having a bird. Lisa's having a bird. She can't handle nothing. She's a crybaby. Why'd she come back from Vegas on Thursday night to harass me? God, she is so bad, Lisa. I wouldn't take her to a freak show. I'd end up being one of the freaks. The dispatcher of record on the phone call that I made to the Nye County Sheriff's for service call of a possible bomb blown off and other stuff that may happen, and no sheriff at all. All it was done, the call was made at 8:51 p.m. The bus was lost at about 9 o'clock. The fire truck came about 9:15, and now it's 10:04. Chief Lewis is talking to Cindy Garrison in the back of Neutral Street, and he said at Matthews Street on Gann, a Matthews property on Gann, if he talked to the two tenants, he would not go to see the RVs. He said he would check tomorrow the whole thing because he can't see. And he said we couldn't go on that property, and yet he was going on the property with me at Matthews. But he wouldn't go to the RV place. It was